How to change a timing belt and a coolant pump. Remove the engine under tray. Place a drain pan under the radiator. Unpick the radiator bottom hose. Remove the engine cover. Open the engine block bleed screw. Open the heater radiator bleed screw. Disconnect the battery negative terminal. Jack up the front of the vehicle and remove the right wheel. Remove the front right hand wheel arch liner. Remove the crankshaft pulley cover. Lock the tensioner roller with a setting rod diameter 4 mm inserted in the roller setting hole. Turn the tensioner roller until the setting rod is in place in the setting hole. The setting rod is in place in the setting hole. Loosen the eccentric roller mounting bolt. Slip the drive belt off the pulleys. Remove the belt. Remove the clutch housing closing plate. Lock the flywheel with a Torx wrench. Loosen the crankshaft pulley bolt. Remove the crankshaft pulley. Move aside the fuel pipes. Remove the up timing cover. Remove the lower timing cover. Refit the crankshaft pulley. Position of the camshaft timing sprocket hole. In order to align the camshaft timing sprocket hole, we must turn a half turn from that position. The camshaft making a half turn for a crankshaft revolution, we must turn the crankshaft one turn. The crankshaft timing hole is located above the starter. The crankshaft timing hole. To replace the timing belt, the engine timing repair tool set for Citroen Peugeot will be very useful. The box contains 2 flywheel stops, a camshaft setting rod, an auxiliary drive belt tension lever. A timing belt tension lever. A crankshaft setting rod. Use the crankshaft setting rod. Peg the flywheel. The crankshaft setting rod is in place. Peg the camshaft pulley. Support the engine with the jack. Remove the ECU. Remove the right-hand engine mounting. Remove the high-pressure pump cover. Memorize the belt tension. The belt should be twisted a little less than a quarter turn in the middle of the longest length of the belt, between two pulleys. Remove the crankshaft pulley. Loosen the timing tensioning roller. Remove the timing belt. Remove the coolant pump bolts. Lower the engine to remove the coolant pump. Remove the coolant pump. Remove the roller. Refit the new roller. Remove the tension roller. Refit the new tension roller. Clean the joint face. Soak the paper seal in the coolant fluid to maintain it in position during the installation. Refit the coolant pump. Refit the radiator bottom hose. Open the heater radiator bleed screw. Open the engine block bleed screw. Fill the cooling system. Close the heater radiator bleed screw as soon as the coolant fluid starts to flow. Fill the cooling system to maximum level. Check that there is no leak from the coolant pump. Slacken the camshaft pulley bolts. Turn the pulley clockwise to the limit at the end of the slots. The new belt isn't marked with directional arrows. When the belt is marked with arrows, the arrows go in clockwise rotation. Use the belt retaining clip. Refit the timing belt on the crankshaft. Place the belt retaining clip. Fit the timing belt on the high pressure pump pulley. Fit the timing belt on the camshaft pulley. Slightly turn the camshaft pulley in the anti-clockwise direction in order to engage the belt on the pinion. Remove the retaining clip. Fit the belt on the coolant pump, then on the tensional roller. Raise the engine. Use the timing belt tension lever. Pre-tension the timing belt in order to be able to twist the belt less than 1/8 of a turn between the two pulleys. Remove bolt on the camshaft pulley. Check that the bolts are not at the limit of the slot. Tighten the camshaft pulley bolts. Remove the camshaft pulley setting rod. Remove the crankshaft setting rod. Refit the crankshaft pulley. Turn the crankshaft 8 times clockwise. Peg the camshaft pulley. Peg the flywheel. Slacken the camshaft pulley bolts. Loosen the tension roller. Tighten the timing belt. The belt should be twisted a little less than a quarter turn between the two pulleys. Tighten the camshaft pulley bolts. Remove the camshaft pulley setting rod. Remove the crankshaft setting rod. Check the belt tension. The belt should be twisted a little less than a quarter turn between the two pulleys. Refit the high pressure pump cover. Refit the right hand engine mounting. Thank you. refit the ECU. Remove the crankshaft pulley. Refit the covers. Refit the fuel pipes. Retrieve the jack. Check the condition of the crankshaft pulley and replace it if necessary. If you replace the crankshaft pulley, the bolts supplied with the new pulley will probably already be coated with pre-applied thread locking. If it is not the case, apply thread locker medium strength to the crankshaft bolt. Lock the flywheel. Tighten the crankshaft pulley bolt. The tightening torque for 206 HDI 2.0 is 40 Newton meter plus 50 degrees angle tighten. Tighten to 40 Newton meter. An angle of 50 degrees represents a little less than one side of bolt. One side equals 60 degrees. Check that the bolt is tightened to at least 195 Newton meter. Remove the Torx wrench. Check the condition of the auxiliary drive belt and replace it if necessary. Refit the belt. Operate the belt from above while you engage the belt on the tensional roller. Use the auxiliary drive belt tension lever. Tension the belt. Tighten to torque the eccentric roller. Remove the setting rod from the tensional roller. Check the belt tension. The belt should be twisted a little less than a quarter turn in the middle of the longest length of the belt. Refit the clutch housing closing plate. Refit the crankshaft pulley cover. Refit the front right-hand wheel arch liner. Refit the wheel. Fill the cooling system. Close the engine block bleed screw as soon as the coolant starts to flow. If the coolant doesn't flow by the bleed screw, disconnect the pipe connecting the expansion tank to the water chamber. Close the bleed screw. Place the pipe end in height and fill the cooling system. Pinch the cooling hoses to remove air bubbles. Stop filling the cooling system as soon as the coolant starts to flow. Reconnect the battery. Start the engine. Top up coolant fluid if necessary. Warm the engine up until the thermostat opens. The radiator top hose gets hot when the thermostat starts to open. Top up coolant fluid if necessary. Check the coolant fluid level during a few days before taking the road and top up if necessary. If the coolant fluid level exceeds the max, remove fluid with a syringe.